Hi, I'm back. So I didn't actually sit here the whole time watching that. I hope you didn't either. I mean, that would have been silly on your part. No, actually, I got some Chex Mix. I went and got myself an ice-cold delicious Pepsi. I enjoyed that for the last 18 minutes or so. I played a dungeon in Final Fantasy Record Keeper. I kept myself occupied while that was happening. Oh, okay. Okay, I see how it is. I think I just want to drop through here, right? Kind of. Yeah, yes. But I can't do it like that. Yeah, just drop through. Nope, never mind. Just drop straight through. Double jump. Double jump again. Double jump again. And we're good. Just had to make that money, that's all. The game doesn't even really reward us with health or stamina upgrades anymore at this point. It's all about that money. Alright, we out. Glad they put a save point there, because I think you could actually die on the thorns in that room. Oh yeah? Oh, it's two of these wizards now. Excellent. And they like to shoot machine guns at you, too. Come on. Oh, God. There we go. I lost myself on screen there for a second. Get him! Ugh! I also ate the machine gun in the face right there, but it's fine. Two more, huh? Yeah, I guess I deserve this. Oh, more than two more. Oh god, it's gonna fill the room up with them. Okay. I don't like where they are up there, to be honest with you. I don't like this at all. This is not good. Ah! If he hadn't moved over, I would have had that. Get out of here. Two headbutts, eh? No? No? Okay. So, if we take these guys down fast, like before any nonsense happens, we avoid getting overwhelmed, break you in the floor. That went really well. When I stayed on top of things there, took them down quickly. Alright, it's gonna be dragons or boners in this room. It's gonna be one of the two, right? Oh no, it won't be. So we don't want to jump off the walls, we just want to make them disappear, otherwise we're jumping the wrong direction, basically. Easy enough. Okay. Those ones go up. Get them all! I don't know why the first two dashes didn't work there. Oh, you know what? We gotta go up. I saw too late what the room wanted me to do. No problem. We got this. There you go. Next. I didn't exactly follow the path there, but it still worked. Nice. Whatever, it worked. Don't laugh at me. Please don't laugh at me. Good news is, it looks like we can always knock these guys off these platforms when I uppercut them. Or I can just punch them to death. Either way. You know, it's their choice, really. I still get credit for the kill if they get knocked off. Oh, what am I doing? I was paying attention to that bone. I didn't realize I was running off the platform. That's one problem with using a D-pad that doesn't have tactile feedback to it, like I'm using on my Steam controller, is I can be resting my thumb on the thing and not realize, oh, I'm walking now. That's probably a bad idea. Uh-oh, the dramatic zoom in. Something awesome's about to happen. Oh, I mean, all the monsters in the world about to attack, is what I mean. Alright, we got this, though. I want to... Oh, the first wizard's dead already. Were those wizards, they have less health than the previous ones? They feel like they went down really quickly. Oh, well. Boom. Hey, look, Olmec is back. Excellent. Can I buy anything? What can I buy with my... I don't need to worry about this, because I'm not playing a two-player. And I'm not going to buy those, because I'm not really grappling. I feel like those would just confuse the issue at this point. Watch how easy the first phase of this Kalaka fight is. I got stuck on this Kalaka fight for so long the first time I played this game, but it's actually relatively easy if you just pay attention to what you're doing. Don't worry, El Presidente's daughter. I'm here to save you from being sacrificed on the Grand Temple. Although, after we kick Kalaka's ass, we ought to move in here. You know, fix the place up a little bit. He just now realized who we are. I mean, I can see why he got confused, because I'm wearing the Alabrehe outfit. Maybe he wasn't sure. The rematch! So all we do here is jump. We wait, and then jump. And then hit him with whatever color shield he's got. Eventually he'll switch to the other realm. And if you're slow, that happens. So don't be slow. And try to always jump away from him if you can. Alright, that's first form. I've got like a third of a health bar to take down the second form. I don't know, I might be able to do it. Uh-oh, this doesn't look good. That's the only example of voice acting in this whole game. That was it. Hey, we need you to scream because you're being tortured on, like, an electric slab. And your skeleton is trying to break out of your body. That's what we need you to do here. So the second form of this boss... Oh, it filled up my health. Never mind. We might got this. Just break his shield. Throw these little meteors at him. He's gonna put up another shield. We're gonna duck here. There we go. He's only got a couple of different attacks, so once you know what he's doing... Ooh, get up there! When he raises his arms, you want to jump. When he pulls his arms back, you want to duck. And when he opens his mouth, he's going to shoot three volleys of fireballs at you. It's just a matter of really learning his attacks. Other than that, though, it's a pretty fun fight. Unless you can't get one of his meteors before his shield goes back up. Nice, we got three of them in there that time. In fact, he's not doing all of his attacks either. There's some of them we haven't even seen yet. I don't know if there's a faster way to break his white shield or not. Timed beautifully. Goatman showed up just as we killed the boss. I grabbed that last meteor just too close to the ground, so the fire erupting from the ground managed to catch me. Which ended my combo, which caused Goatman to show up and be like, "Hey, congrats on the kick-ass combo." Oh, what's this now? I ask as I stand underneath this statue's crotch. Hey, we got the top of a... something. But whatever, we win the game, that's it. So now we can double jump, uppercut, dash, headbutt, frog slam! I beat the statue down here, guys. It was a race. You didn't know it was a race, did you? Oh, I don't know if I like this sad music that's playing right now. And her lips look awful blue. And her body looks awful limp. We destroyed Kalaka and saved the world. But lost El Presidente's daughter. That's too bad. I mean, like, I can't even really enjoy the happy ending now. I'm not really convinced that Juan knows how to swim, because there's no water anywhere in the game. But, I don't know. I suppose he looks relatively contented to be a bachelor luchador for the rest of his days. I mean, he's a superhero, essentially. Everybody who's tasted his tortillas would agree that Juan is a superhero. And he taught that chicken how to play the trumpet. So he's keeping busy, basically. He's keeping busy. I wonder whose birthday it is in that shot. Probably Goatman's. Probably Goatman's birthday. Oh, he's a superhero and a soccer player. I guess a football player, I should say, considering this does take place in Mexico. And Mexican football is soccer. That's a weird cultural thing that I'm always like... It always takes me a second to realize I'm on the wrong side of that particular cultural wall. Because I live in the only country in the world that doesn't call soccer football. We call it soccer. We have another sport called football. See, they're reunited in the land of the dead. After Juan lives a long and happy life as a superhero, tortilla-making soccer player. So hard difficulty is now available. I've tried hard difficulty in this game. I don't like it. It's mostly just make the game not fun difficulty. It says there are still hidden secrets to be found. So, I don't know. I guess we'll get to it. I'll see you tomorrow. Shoutouts to Skylar Ward for sponsoring this video, and to everybody who helped make my channel possible by supporting me on Patreon.